In this month of January, under the patronage of Don Bosco and St. Francis de Sales, ANS, the Salesian News Agency, intends to offer you the ANS News Video, a monthly news bulletin reviewing the most important events that have taken place across the broad spectrum of the Salesian Congregation, from the Rector Major and his Council, extending to all the regions and the peripheries of the Salesian world. It will be an easier way to view, grasp, and understand all that is being done in the name of Don Bosco for the education and evangelization of young people. Rome Generalate. Do all through love, nothing through constraint. As per tradition, at the end of the year, the Rector Major, Father Angel Fernandez Artime, delivered his Strana message to the Salesian family. On 27th December, he gave a preview of the Strana to the daughters of Mary Help of Christians at their general house. The following day, he explained in a live interview the central points of his message on the theme, Do All Through Love, Nothing Through Constraint. It was later released on ANS YouTube channel in the other languages most spoken in the congregation. The video pays tribute to St. Francis de Sales on the 400th anniversary of his death and highlights how Don Bosco admired and imitated his patience, amiability, his great charity, and intense prayer. Salesian Family Spirituality Days 2020. The 40th edition of the Salesian Family Spirituality Days took place from 13th to 16th January, an event during which the 32 groups of the Salesian Family experienced times for meeting and reflecting on the themes that inspire their mission. The days were held in mixed mode. About 200 representatives of the Salesian family groups took part live in activities at Baldoco in Turin, while viewers from all over the world were able to follow live streaming of the events, translated in real time. At the core of the meetings was the message of this year's Strana from the Rector Major, Do all through love, nothing through constraints, an exhortation taken from St. Francis de Sales. An exhibition was dedicated to the saint at the Casa Don Bosco Museum, inaugurated during those days. In addition to the presentation of the Strana by the Rector Major, there were many opportunities for discussion on Salesian spirituality, from the round table on St. Francis de Sales to the testimonies of experiences of spirituality in action. Salesian January on TV. The initiative of Salesian Masses, broadcasted on the main Italian television channels for the entire month of January, was a great success. From the first day of the month until the 31st of January, TV 2000, the Italian Bishop's broadcaster, broadcasted three daily Masses live from the Salesian Sacred Heart Basilica in Rome. In addition, the Sunday morning Masses was also broadcasted by the national channel Canale 5. And on Sunday, 30th of January, on the eve of the saint of the Feast of Don Bosco, the Mass celebrated by the Rector Major, Father Angel Fernandez Artime, from the Basilica of Mary Help of Christians in Turin, was broadcasted live on Rai Uno, the prime Italian network. In this way, the Salesian Masses, some of them celebrated by the members of the General Council, were followed by over a million faithful every day, with peaks of almost 2 million for the Rector Major's Mass on the 30th of January. And among the hundreds of thousands of faithful who followed that particular celebration was also Pope Francis, as he himself testified immediately after the Angelus on that Sunday.
Ho seguito la messa celebrata nel santuario di Maria Ausiliatrice dal Rettore Maggiore Angel Fernandez Artime. Ho pregato con lui per tutti.
The 8th EU's General Assembly. The 8th General Assembly of the Salesian Institutes of Higher Education was held at Salesian Headquarters in Rome from the 24th to the 28th of January, involving some 50 individuals with positions of responsibility in the sector. The specific aim was to reflect together to draw up proposed strategies whose implementation can ensure that Salesian institutions of higher education succeed in evolving their educational offerings while remaining firmly rooted in their identity. The Assembly concluded with the approval of three fundamental documents: the election of continental coordinators for upcoming mandates, the planning of dates for the upcoming continental conferences, and the presentation of the coordination key. And finally, the concluding Eucharist presided over by the Rector Major, Father Angel Fernandez Sardi. Booklet on Salesian Parishes and Shrines. The official presentation of the booklet on the parishes and shrines entrusted to the Salesians took place on the 10th and 11th January in various languages through the Zoom platform. More than 600 Salesians and lay people from all the provinces around the world took part. During these meetings, reflections were shared on the parish and shrine entrusted to the Salesians in the Youth Ministry Frame of Reference. The result of work done some years ago in the provinces and by the youth ministry sector in order to identify paths and proposals. The contributions from the Rector Major and the General Counselor for Youth Ministry, Father Miguel Angel Garcia Marquende, were also of great importance. Formation and Integral Ecology. In response to the results from the questionnaires on integral ecology administered in recent months to all Salesian provinces and houses around the world, the youth ministry sector has decided to offer a basic 90-minute formation session on this important topic. This is a brief formation opportunity that will retrace the steps to understand the true meaning of integral ecology and to move from the culture of waste to the culture of care. In addition, the session addresses how to integrate integral ecology into the Salesian educative and pastoral projects, both local and provincial, through concrete activities. The formation sessions will be organized online for small groups upon request and according to the number of participants. To book, just write to Dr. Emanuela Chiang, a member of the Youth Ministry Center. Postulation Dossier 2021. In January, the General Postulation for the Causes of Saints of the Salesian Family released the Postulation Dossier 2021, a document that gives an account of countless men and women, young people and adults, consecrated and lay people, bishops and missionaries, who from Don Bosco to the present day in different contexts, have made the Salesian charism shine with a unique light. The Salesian postulation is interested in 173 figures of holiness, including 9 saints, 118 blessed, 18 venerables, 28 servants of God. There are 58 causes followed directly by the postulation.
18 venerabili e 28 servi di Dio.
Course for Salesian Family Delegates. At the end of the Salesian Family Spirituality Days in Valdocco and in the Salesian places in Piedmont, another event sharing the Salesian spirit took place for some members of the different groups, the Course for Salesian Family Delegates. The week of work from 16 to 22 January was characterized by an atmosphere of fraternity and by the shared awareness of being responsible together for a great gift. Within the rich program of activities, the introductory address by Father Angel Fernandez Artime, Rector Major of the Salesians and Father and Center of Unity of the Salesian Family, stood out. He also stressed the importance of understanding the Salesian family as a charismatic family at the service of the Church and for the world, experiencing a youthful and missionary mission to ordinary people. SYM celebrates Salesian St. Francis de Sales. The Executive Council, involving leaders of the Salesian Youth Movement, unanimously approved the proposal to celebrate the 400th anniversary of the death of St. Francis de Sales during 2022. The members of the Africa-Madagascar Regional Council have been charged with coordinating this event, in which all the groups of the Salesian Youth Movement in Salesian provinces will participate. The initiatives include moments of prayer on the most important days linked to the memory of the saints, the work of young people creating video messages inspired by the life and teachings of the saints, or the 2022 Strena, as well as paintings and drawings dedicated to him. Africa Madagascar region. And now we come to the main events that took place in January in the Salesian Africa Madagascar region. Tunisia, oratories together in Manobo. The first Oratory and Assembly Day in Tunis was held in Manobo, in the Salesian House that was founded about 30 years ago and is now an elementary school and youth center. Children, animators, and leaders from the new oratory in the center of Tunis, built at the Don Bosco School formerly belonging to the Marianists, had their first outing and went to share a day of sports, games, and group activities with the firstborn Manobo Oratory, established in 2013, thanks to the dedication of the Salesian brother Roberto Lionelli, currently serving in Madagascar. Kenya, extraordinary visitation to East Africa. The extraordinary visitation of the East Africa province, which includes Salesian presences in Kenya, Sudan, South Sudan, and Tanzania, began a few days ago at the Provincial House in Nairobi and at the Shrine of Mary Help of Christians in Upper Hill. Father Vaclav Clement is the extraordinary visitor on behalf of the Rector Major. The letter sent to the AFE Salesians by the Rector Major was also read out, specifying the general goals of the visitation: to intensify communion, animate the religious life of the communities, and verify the pastoral fulfillment of the mission and a specific goal on the reorganization of the province on which the AFE province has been reflecting and discerning for 12 years. Zambia, Clean Water Initiative. St. James Parish in Kimese, a village in Zambia, can now boast of a new well that draws clean water, a water tank more than 7 meters high, a solar-powered pump, and a network of pipes inside its premises, all of which is made available to the local people. All this has been made possible thanks to the solidarity efforts by Salesian Missions, the New Rochelle Salesian Missions Agency. South Sudan, Salesian Solidarity for Gumpo. The Salesians have been carrying out an immense amount of work in Gumbo for years. They run a parish, an elementary school with 1,800 students, a high school with 450 students, a technical school, an oratory, and a camp for refugees with about 9,500 people. Now supporting this project is the Don Bosco Salesian Missionary Foundation from Warsaw. Thanks to the support of various organizations, including Polish Aid, they have built a new building for the elementary school, where it has been possible to teach 140 students per class. America South Cone. Historic anniversaries, new commitments, and care for our common home are the hallmarks of the news that marked January in the Salesian America South Cone region. Brazil, 120 years of presence among the Boro. 18th of January 2022 marked 120 years of Salesian presence in the indigenous Meruri Mission in Mato Grosso, Brazil. The first group of Salesians and Daughters of Mary Help of Christians arrived in the Bororo lands on 18th of January 1902 and launched their first mission in the region of Tacos. There, they had their first contact with the Bororo people, later developing educational and self-supporting activities. The mission was then transferred to the region near Moro de Meruri, giving rise to the current village of Meruri, the main community and headquarters of the Salesian Mission to this day. The Salesian Mission promotes various projects to improve the lives of the indigenous people. Brazil, parish dedicated to St. Francis de Sales. The official erection of the Salesian parish dedicated to St. Francis de Sales took place on Sunday, 23rd of January, in the auditorium of the Don Bosco Salesian Institute in Belo Horizonte. On the same occasion, Father Jose Paulino de Godoy Jr., SDB, was installed as pastor, and Father Geraldo Martins Lisboa, SDB, was entrusted with the task of assistant priest. The celebration was presided over by Bishop Nivaldo dos Santos Ferreira, auxiliary bishop of the Archdiocese of Belo Horizonte, and in charge of the Episcopal region of Nossa Senhora Aparecida. Uruguay, Bachelors in Integral Ecology. The St. Francis de Sales Salesian College and High School in Maturana, Montevideo, has begun a course called the Baccalaureate in Integral Ecology this year. It has been declared of interest by the Uruguayan government's Ministry of the Environment. The aim is to accompany young people in forming environmental awareness of citizens through an active pedagogy by educating in an interdisciplinary way and drawing inspiration from the encyclical Laudato Si and Salesian spirituality. This is a proposal that makes the 8th Action Guideline for 2020 to 2026 concrete. The Uruguayan Minister of the Environment, the Honorable Adrian Peña, praised the work at the end of his visit to the facility. East Asia-Oceania region. We now turn to the East Asia-Oceania region, for which this January brought great challenges, but also moments of celebration. Philippines, Hope After Rai Odette. The Category 5 Typhoon Rai, locally referred to as Odette, devastated most of the Visayas and Northern Mindanao region of the Philippines in late December, causing over 400 deaths and thousands of displaced persons. The Don Bosco Formation Center in Lawan was not spared by the disaster. However, thanks to the Salesians, aspirants, young people from the Don Bosco Youth Center, and the mission's lay staff who worked tirelessly, the place was cleaned up, the water was restored, and there was a chance to provide electricity using a generator. As a result, the Formation Center was able to help nearby communities by donating clean water and a charging station for electronic devices. East Timor, Feast of Don Bosco with the Regional. The St. Calistus Caraballo Vice Province of Timor-Leste, Salesian Family, celebrated the Feast of St. John Bosco on 31st January in the presence of the Regional Counselor for the East Asia-Oceania region, Father Joseph Fook, SDB. The Eucharistic celebration, presided over by the Vice Provincial, Father Manuel Pinto, SDB, was held in the parish of Mary Help of Christians in Comoro Dili, with many members of the Salesian Family and the Salesian Youth Movement. A testimony to the vitality of the religious family originated by Don Bosco that is at the service of the Church and the Timorese society. Thailand, Salesian Family Day. On the 22nd of January, 60 members of the various groups of the Thai Salesian Family gathered at Sabio House in Samprat Nakhon Pathom to celebrate Salesian Family Day. The event was coordinated by Father Nopadon Joseph, delegate for the Thai Salesian Family. Participants witnessed the presentation of the Rector Major's Trena 2022 and the official opening of the celebrations of the 400th anniversary of the death of St. Francis de Sales. In addition, they also celebrated the 50th anniversary of the Association of Salesian Cooperators of Thailand. The climax of the day was reached with the celebration of the Eucharist, presided over by the Bishop Joseph Pratan Sridharun Sil, SDB, Bishop of Surat Thani, and during which two new Salesian cooperators made their prize. South Asia region. Let's stay in Asia, but let's move this time to the Indian subcontinent for the South Asia region. January was a month of important celebrations and splendid gestures of solidarity. 100 years of Salesian presence in the Northeast India. Celebrations for the centenary of the Salesian presence in Northeast India got underway on Wednesday, 12th of January 2022 in Guwahati. The ceremony included a solemn mass, preceded by the raising of the centenary flag by the chief guest, Archbishop John Molachira, Archbishop of Guwahati, at the Salesian Provincial House. Today, we congratulate the Salesian Society for its presence and phenomenal contribution. We are grateful to the Salesians for what they have done, what they are doing, and what they will continue to do for the people of Northeast India, the prelate commented on the occasion. Hyderabad Birthday celebrates 25 years. On the 15th of January, the Bosco Institute of Research and Development for Youth, BIRDI, celebrated its first 25 years of accompanying the youth of the Hyderabad province. The work was launched in 1996 in the presence of the late Father Thomas Panakaran, the then Regional Counselor for Asia, and Father Joe Arimpur, Founder Director of BIRDI. The Salesian work is aimed at young people, especially the marginalized and the poor, through various leadership programs. It has also reached out to young workers and educators. During the 25th anniversary mass, the provincial, Father Tatireddy Vijaya Bhaskar, highlighted the work's continued commitment to marginalized and disadvantaged youth. Snehabedu, a home for Anidi family. Volunteers from Don Bosco Arts and Science College, Angadikadaru, in the state of Kerala, district of Kannur, have built and handed over a house called Snehabedu, the House of Love, to Anidi family in the district. The beneficiaries are a woman and her two children, a boy of 10 with mental problems, and another younger son of 6 with a kidney disease, who can now be welcomed in a new house. The Bishop of Kannur, Bishop Alex Vadakumtala, commented, "I am happy and proud of what the young people from Don Bosco College have done. In our schools, together with concepts, we need to transmit human values. Because in the end, studying does not only mean obtaining a diploma, but extending our heart and mind to our neighbors who suffer." Central North Europe region. From Ukraine to Germany via Poland, the Central and Northern Europe region saw a month marked by new perspectives, feast days, and important confirmations. Ukraine, a Salesian oratory in Zhytomyr. In Ukraine, in Zhytomyr, the Svesit School has stood since September 1994. It was built thanks to the interest of some Italian benefactors who, during a trip to the countries of the former USSR, decided to give a concrete response to the appeal of a group of citizens wishing to open a Christian school. That school, almost 2 years ago, and after several years of cooperation and preparation, has become a Salesian one. And now the sons of Don Bosco, who run it, intend to place another typically Salesian structure alongside the educational center, an oratory to all the children and young people of the neighborhood. Poland, Salesian youth in the Magi procession. On the 6th of January, following a tradition that began in 2008, processions of the Magi were held in over 600 Polish cities and towns, an evangelization initiative that takes its cue from the traditional celebrations of the Epiphany. One of these processions took place in Kraków, involving, as it does every year, the Młodzi Suatu Salesian Missionary Volunteers, part of the Green Group in the procession, and one of the three kings was played by the young Vietnamese Salesian Nguyen Hung Truong, a student at the Salesian Theologate in Kraków. The entire journey of the Green Group began with a mass in the Salesian St. Stanislaus Kotska Church in Dębniki and continued with Christmas carols in an atmosphere of true joy and peace. The initiative also had a charitable purpose. Germany, Don Bosco Volunteers Movement leaves its mark. Volunteer programs abroad, such as the Don Bosco Volunteers, often lead to lasting volunteer service. Thus, the finding of a survey of former volunteers conducted by the German province on the program's 25th anniversary. Of the 180 volunteers who participated in the survey, 91% said they were politically and socially engaged once they returned home. For example, in youth work, student associations, or helping refugees. And 50% are also involved more than once a week. The survey was carried out because of the 25th anniversary of the German Salesian Volunteer Program. Inter-America. For the Inter-America region, January was a time for grateful remembrance for some illustrious Salesians and for several important anniversaries. Adieu to Father Arthur Lenti. Arthur Lenti, a Salesian known throughout the congregation and far beyond for his writings on Don Bosco, and in particular for his monumental work, Don Bosco, History and Spirit, whose 7 volumes, translated into many languages, has become classics of Salesian literature. Father Lenti lived practically all of his Salesian life in the United States of America and spent his talents engaging above all in the apostolate of teaching and research as a professor of sacred scripture and as founder and teacher of Don Bosco Hall, 1974, and of the Salesian Spirituality Institute in Berkeley, 1984. Peru province celebrates 120 years. 20th of January 2022 marked the 120th anniversary of the canonical erection of the Saint Rose of Lima province. In fact, although the Salesian presence in the country dates back to 1891, in the early years, Salesian houses belonged to provinces based in other countries in the region. Over time, however, the Salesian charism flourished and new work sprang all over the country until on 28 January 1902, a new province was created with headquarters in Breña, Lima, and placed under the patronage of St. Rose of Lima, still the patroness of Peru. 120 years later, it is possible to see how Father Rua's desire is being fulfilled, that of making this province the great driving force for achieving Don Bosco's dream in the country. 75 years of Salesian missions, Eurochannel. Beginning this month, Salesian Missions, the Salesian Missions Office based in Eurochannel, United States, joyfully celebrates its 75th anniversary, a significant milestone in its long and fruitful history of working with so many generous people. In 1947, Father James O'Loughlin founded the office with the purpose of telling the stories of Salesian works and raising support for missions. Among the various directors, it is worth mentioning Father Edward Ed Capelletti, who took over the direction of Salesian missions in 1959 and kept it for the next 44 years. It was he who thought up the idea of scouring local telephone directories in search of Catholic surnames, and who provided for the manual collection of addresses in a mailing list of benefactors. Today, the Missions Office works to support the work of nearly 30,000 missionaries in the Salesian Family and has improved the lives and futures of more than 3 million children in more than 130 countries around the world. Mediterranean Region. Finally, we complete our tour around the Salesian world with a look at the Mediterranean region. Spain. EU's motorsport launches a challenge. The EU's motorsport is a multidisciplinary team made up of engineering students from the Salesian University School in Sarria, EU's, which was founded in 2017 and has been participating for 5 years in the SAE Formula Student Tournament, a worldwide competition with more than 800 participating universities. In this tournament, the team is called upon to design and build a working single-seater, putting into practice all that is learned in the Salesian Center. Between the end of last year and the beginning of the new one, the team designed the new car, the EM04, and this February, the construction phase began. The final single-seater will then compete in the summer with the other competitors in an evaluation process that includes also factors such as the business plan, consumption, cost analysis. Salesian CFPs, vocational training centers, lead the way in innovation. Salesian centers that provide students with vocational job training have once again demonstrated all their strengths. This is evidenced by the latest convocation of the Spanish Ministry of Education, which lists a dozen of these centers among those chosen to develop national innovation projects in the vocational training field. The ministerial convocation lists 141 initiatives, and the Salesian vocational training representatives are involved in more than 10 of them. Most of these initiatives stand out for their innovation in terms of Industry 4.0, Internet of Things, collaborative robotics, smart manufacturing, digitization and 3D printing, drone management, and artificial intelligence. 150 years for San Pier d'Arena, Genoa. In 2022, it is also worth remembering the 150th anniversary of the Salesian presence in San Pier d'Arena in Genoa. It was in November 1872 that the first Salesian settled in San Pier d'Arena district of the port city, led by Father Paul Albera. To celebrate the 150th anniversary of their presence, the Salesians there have planned a program of activities that will develop throughout 2022, and which was opened on 29 January by the presentation of the Serena by the Vicar of the Rector Major, Father Stefano Martoglio. It continued with the Eucharist on 30th of January, celebrated by Cardinal Angelo Bagnasco, Archbishop Emeritus of Genoa. In addition, to celebrate the anniversary, the Salesian community committed itself to collaborating with former students and businesses in the area to launch 150 young people into work, one for every year of the Salesian presence in San Pier d'Arena. Well then, With this final item of news, we have concluded this first edition of ANS News Video. But this is not the end of our commitment to recounting and spreading the good things that are being done throughout the Salesian world in the name of Don Bosco. We look forward to seeing you in February for a new episode. Don't miss it!